So, what are the different types and their applications? First one is the unit load system. So, in this system, each storage space we are going to store only one component or one part is stored in one area. So, the racks will be having a pallets, and on top of the pallet, the workpieces are mounted, and the pallet will be placed inside the racks. Whenever it is to be stored, it will be taken out whenever it is required for processing. Now the distance between the racks will be such that they are uniform throughout. So a lot of space is wasted because of the uniform gap between the various racks. So what kind of components can be stored over here? So large components mounted in fixtures, they can be stored very easily and they can be retrieved very easily. It can be completely automated. The individual storage points can be programmed very easily so that a automated system can load the component into the storage area, or it can pick up and deliver in this particular system. So any component can be individually picked, or it can be dispatched back to the machining station as per the requirement. Main advantage of unit load system is the accessibility of each and every component. So a large variety of components can be stored. Next one is
But
the
the
main
deep plane
disadvantage
system,
is since the racks have got some
in
limitation
case
of
of
their
the
unit
width or
load
the
system,
spacing,
you are
so
a lot of
individually
space
able
to
may be
access each
wasted
and
because
every
of the
different sizes and
storage
shape
space
of the
over here,
components. You can
which
take
may
out the
not be
component and you can
effectively
put it
stored
back.
in the given
But in
space. That
case
is
of the
the
main
deep plane
disadvantage
system.
of unit load
It
system,
is not possible
the
to
other advantage
individually
is
access
any number of different
each and
products
every
can be
component.
stored because each of them can be individually accessed. Next one is the deep plane system. In this case, large number of products can be stored. So here you are having the access in the X direction, you can say in the Y direction, and also in the Z direction you can store many components. Lot of space is utilized, it is not wasted unlike in the unit load system, whereas in between every two racks a space is required for the movement so that the components are picked out and it are stored back. In case of the deep plane system, it is not the case. But the main disadvantage is each and every component stored cannot be accessed because the loading will take place from one side, the unloading is going to take place from the other side. So as the components are loaded, they are going to be moving forward, and whatever component is required, it is pulled out from the other end. So what is the advantage of this? So lot of storage is possible in a given area, and the system works based on first in and first out system. The first components whichever are placed, they are the ones which are going to go out first. So these type of systems are more commonly used for storing perishable items so that the older items are used up faster. So what are the disadvantages? Disadvantage is the product variety that can be stored. Since the loading and unloading can happen from fixed ends, so loading will always happen from here, unloading is going to happen from the other end. So individual storage points cannot be accessed very easily. So each slot will have one particular kind of component. So because of which the number of products, different products which can be stored is significantly lesser. Because one lane, you can call this as a lane, one lane will contain only one type of product, and the number of lanes will limit the number of products, and it is not dependent on the number of spaces or number of products that can be stored. It is dependent on the number of individual lanes that are available. Whereas in case of the unit load system, each and every unit can be a different product that can be stored. So deep plane system has got higher capacity to store, but the variety is significantly reduced. Products are loaded up from one end, it are unloaded or picked out from the other end. Next one is a mini load system. This is mainly used when the products that are to be stored are very small in size. So you will be usually having, instead of pallets, you will be having something called as a bins, and in the bins you are loading and unloading the components. The bins are brought to the pickup and dispatch area or the loading and unloading point. The required components are pulled out from the bins. Whatever is not required, the bins are sent back into the storage area for retrieval in the future. So mini load system means in one given space or storage point or storage area, multiple components of same variety can be stored. For example, a bin may contain hundreds of fasteners or bars of particular length which are to be turned or which are heat treated and they are stored for some period of time. So the bin can be pulled out. From the bin, some 10 or 20 numbers which are required can be taken out. Whatever balance is there, that can be sent back into the storage. So that is a mini load system. So within one storage space, more than one component is stored. Next one is a man on board system. In case of the mini load system, usually the bins are being pulled out from the storage space, brought to the loading and unloading area. Again, after taking out the components, the bins are sent back. So it involves a lot of material movement. In order to avoid this, you are having something called as a man on board system, wherein the material handling system will be having a space for the human operator to position himself. The material handling system is going to move and the human operator is going to pick out the components from the bins depending on the requirement, and then as the material handling system moves, the person will be picking on the various components required, and once he reaches the loading and unloading area, the different components are segregated or sent to various machining centers depending on the requirement. So here the main difference is the bins are not pulled out, but the human being is going to the various bins. He is taking the components which are required, or he is filling into the bins depending on the requirement. Next one is the automated retrieval system. In this case, you are having lot of conveyor systems. Whatever components are required, they are dropped onto the conveyors. The conveyors are going to move the parts dropped on top of them into the loading and unloading area so that the required components are received at the loading and unloading area. So here you require some specialized systems to drop the required components on top of the conveyor. Whatever particular variety is required, that has to be dropped onto the conveyor, and the conveyor is going to move and bring the components to the loading and unloading area. The last variety is the vertical lift storage modules. This is slightly different from the carousel system, where in the carousel system the different bins are going to move. The storage bins are not moving. They are only stacked one over the other as shown. The material handling system is going to move the bins from one location to the another location so that the components are loaded into the bins or they are unloaded from the bins. So if the storage system can run as high as 10 meters without much of a issues. So these are very compact and can be used for storing smaller sized components more effectively. That is the main advantage. Carousel systems occupy lesser space, but their cost is significantly higher because of their nature of the movement of the bins. So whatever system is there, it should have the capability to move the entire weight whenever the components are to be loaded or unloaded. But in case of the vertical lift storage system, only the bin whichever is required has to be picked out, and the movement of the material system should be able to withstand the weight of one bin. So each and every storage location can be individually identified. The location can be programmed and the computer system will remember what is present in which particular location so that it knows the status of the various components which are present in each of these systems. So this is applicable for all the material handling systems. That is why we call them as automatic storage and retrieval, because the computer system which is operating this will know how many components are present, what component is present, what is the status of that particular component present at each of these locations. So every storage locations will be individually referenced, and the computer system will know what is the status of the components that are stored.